Larry, please, we gotta talk. There's been a terrible misunderstanding.
You will never be able to escape this prison. Serve your 1,000-year sentence.
1,000 years? I'll be a dusty old skelly. Unless I come up with a plan to bust out of this place. Now, let's see what we're working with here. Warden Larry, guard in the hall with his super cool tattoos. Got it? A sink full of acid, unlikely to help me. This kitten encouraging me to believe that I can bust out of here. Wow, I feel inspired. Let's do it. Goodbye to my bacon cellmate. I cannot stay here. I crave freedom. Oh, wow. That was easy. Plot twist on the whole prison escape situation. Turns out the bars just fall off when gently pushed. It's almost too easy. Wait a second. Warning, police shark-infested waters below. What do you mean by police shark? Kind of feels like two scary words just smooshed together. Now, are we talking police officers that have managed to transform themselves into sharks, or are we talking about sharks who are working with the cops? New fear unlocked. Acid is bad for your lungs. Keep away at all costs. I like how I originally thought this prison escape was going to be so easy, and now I'm dealing with police sharks and acid at the same time. And we haven't even started to talk about the cockroach infestation that's happening here at the prison. It's like there's a terrifying fear for everybody. Okay, I gotta drain this acid. Turn all three valves to drain. Okay, I'm a little bit worried about where the acid is draining to. Beautiful, scenic, waterfront, mountain scenes happening outside of the prison here. Are we just, like, draining this acid directly into the bay? Because that seems like a terrible idea. Like, obviously, I'm afraid of Warden Larry and I want to escape, but I might be more scared of that angry otter family who lives in the bay. But the acid, she a draining, and that's a problem for later. Oh, hey there, friend. Are you also escaping this facility? Got any tips on how to deal with police sharks and irate otters? Yeah, me neither, but I'll let you know if I think of anything. Now that all that pesky acid is out of the way, I can finally get down the stairs and find the hidden button. Wait a second, there's a poster here that I'm a bit interested in. Albatross Island Prison! Press the button and protecting the people since 1935.
Huh? Get back to your cell!
Who, me? Oh yeah, no problem, I can totally get back in my cell. I'm certainly not trying to sneak around the guard and find the key. Yeah, I'll just pop back in here. There's no need to chase me because I am in the cell now. And okay, you're still chasing me. All good because there's a hole in the wall and maybe I can find a way to lock you in this cell, Larry. Or I don't need to because you are just stuck in the bars. He's not that smart, is he? Oh, the key. That's a win. A win for me. Who said that? Ow, my head. So I got overconfident and the comeuppance arrived swiftly. This time I will not be underestimating Larry. Think I've already got the key, so does that mean that I can just head straight up here? Can Larry use stairs? Doesn't look like. Kind of looks like he's trapped. Do I open this door and— Oh nope, that is Mr. Smiley's cell. We shall be leaving that alone. Mr. Smiley, don't you go thinking that I've forgotten what happened in the daycare. Okay, here's the right door. And my kitten friend is here to tell me to believe. Believe that I can plunge to the core of the earth. Or the basement of the prison. I mean, this could be a good way to escape. Those bars do seem like they would do a good job at keeping out police sharks. But evidently, the path forward is the vent. So let's head for the vent. Love how there's so many other prisoners down here trying to escape. Like, what up, Sarah? The camaraderie? Unbeatable. And okay, she's sliding. The face first sliding. Okay, well, at least we didn't slide into the lava. Love that for me. Ah yes, the traditional Roblox pit of magma. I love how this game is hitting every deep fear. Like, we've got acid, we've got police sharks, we've got cockroaches, and now, a lake of fire. Please vote in the comment section for which one of these you think is the most terrifying. And if you have any other suggestions, I'm sure the obby creators are always looking for something horrifying. What's with these fireballs? They really don't leave you much time to get past, and oh my gosh, they're really, really hot. I can feel my eyebrows singeing. Yeah, let's get out of the volcano section of the prison. I feel like good things do not happen in the volcano section of the prison. But on the upside, it's been a while since we've seen Larry the Warden, which does make me think that maybe he doesn't even know that this volcano section of the prison exists. That or he's very scared of magma. A second set of golden handcuffs for me, a nice little collectible. Don't mind it. And then what better way to escape than to blast myself into freedom? Or maybe the garbage area. I think I'm in the dumpster. And not only am I covered in garbage shoes, but also my school bully Jimmy appears to be a fellow inmate. Hey Jimmy, are we friends now? We went to the same school and— Okay, yep, that sounds about right. Jimmy's like, we weren't friends on the outside and we're not friends now. Well, luckily Jimmy also not so smart. So I can probably just sneak behind him. Maybe I can jump over here. can't get over the fence, so I'm just gonna go right behind him. I feel like he won't even notice. Oh, no, oh my gosh. Have they hired my high school gym teacher to work at the prison? This is like my own personal nightmare. Like the indignity of being wrongfully convicted and having to serve a 1,000-year sentence, that is enough. But you're saying I have to serve that time with my high school bully and my least favorite teacher. I cannot think of anything worse. Like literally, bring on the police sharks. I am ready for it. Like that is an epic would you rather question. I'm putting it up on the community board. Like, would you rather swim in shark cop infested waters or serve 1,000 years in prison with your bully and your least favorite teacher?
So you really thought you could escape my prison? Compared to the other monsters here, this is easy.
Psst, kid.
Oh good, all of my historic enemies return. Clean up my tables and I'll let you escape through the kitchen. My brand new Kawaii Kunicorn coloring book is now available on Amazon. Follow the link in the description. An unexpected ally. Incredible redemption arc for the lunch lady. Enemies to friends, we love to see it. I'm gonna go ahead and assume that she's not just using me for the free labor, and actually we are on the verge of becoming besties. People will be like, oh my gosh, how did you two become friends? And I'll be like, it's a funny story, actually. I was escaping prison, so she was a lunch lady, I was an inmate, classic tale. Anyway, one day I was being chased by the warden and she was like, bestie, escape through the kitchen. And I was like, dang, maybe I will build a pile of boxes so that I can claim another pair of golden handcuffs and then find a vent to escape through. So this is where it all begins, I guess. A beautiful friendship. Sure am glad that there's lots of boxes of inventory here that don't seem to have been unpacked yet. Something nice and solid for me to build a little tower. Bash this vent in. All right, we're in the vent. We're venting. We're going full vent. I have been vent-pilled. All right, hopefully this is the outside. Nope, it's a weird toy room. What's going on here? Those things look a little bit familiar. And oh no, it's Darlin. I am obsessed with the number of characters that are in this obby. This is so much fun. Let me know in the comment section how many of these obbies you've played. Tee-hee-hee. Join me for a tea party if you want inside. Signed, Darlin. Well, I've actually played Darlin's Dollhouse, so there is no way I am going in the warden's office. I do not trust that tea. Oh my gosh, the outside! Oh, this is good. This is promising. I think we're making some progress. Just got to avoid a little bit of light electrocution, and I should be swimming in cop shark-infested waters in no time. I never thought I would be so happy to say that. Obviously, I'm hoping for some sort of boat, but I would settle for a paddleboard. I'd even settle for one of those unicorn floaties. Okay, we got a bit of a laser situation here. The sign says to find cover to pass through the lasers. Can I just jump on this box? Oh, can I go in the box? I am the box. I am confused why the lasers don't cut the box. What is going on here? I said no thank you to attending Darlin's tea party, but it appears that I am attending whether I like it or not. What are the chances I could just sneak around the side without Darlin noticing? She does seem to be staring straight ahead. It's pretty creepy. If I can just avoid slipping in any of the tea she spilled on the ground, I might be able to get away with it. This might be loud. Better hurry. Okay, quick, before she notices and then just run down the vent. Is she behind me? I hope she's not behind me. Okay. We seem to be safe. I bet she didn't even notice I was there. I am so sneaky, just sneaking around the vents. And what's with the giant pair of scissors? A gift for you. Let's play again sometime. Darlin! Okay, I am a fool. She obviously knew I was there. Nice present, though. Wait, this looks like a situation that needs a pair of giant scissors. Release all prisoners, Darlin, another unexpected ally? Wait a second, what's happening?
You really thought you could escape prison, eh? It's time to go back to your cell.
Sorry, Larry, but that's not gonna happen. I gotta hit that button. 1v1, and I have a blasty cannon. This should be easy enough. Is Larry's only weapon these rotating handcuffs? Oh, nope, there's a mini warden. They're so small and cute. Might just blast him, though, anyway. Alright, Larry, I see how it is. Slightly more complicated when we have the tiny warden chasing me and the handcuffs. But I still think I'm gonna win this one. Almost got him. Stay out of my way, mini warden. I did it. He's falling. And that means I get to press this big, exciting button. Release all prisoners, please. Whoa, was that me twice? Oh, and Mr. Smiley. Oh, good. I forgot about him. That's a bummer. Beautiful day for a prison escape, though. Ow, my face. This is so embarrassing. Pretend you didn't see that. You didn't see me fall. You just saw a dramatic prison escape. It was graceful. It was triumphant. It is apparently gonna end with a flying fox. Oh my gosh, that is so majestic. This is how I want you to remember me. Flying to freedom. The wind in my hair, my palms, quite sweaty, but just don't think about that too much. We're feeling strong, we're feeling powerful, we're heading for cup shark-infested waters, but I think I see a boat. Not just any boat, that looks like a luxury yacht. Huge vibe if I escape prison in a luxury yacht. Imagine the look on the girly's face when they think that I am serving a 1,000-year sentence and then I cruise on into the harbor. Okay, so maybe a small detail, but do we know who the boat belongs to? Whose boat is this? Am I stealing a boat? Is this another crime? Am I doing a larceny? I've only been out of prison for like less than 10 seconds, and I think I'm already doing crime. But on the other hand, freedom and a badge.